Yeah. Heavenly Father, you are a miracle worker, and day after day we expect your miracle. Therefore, Jehovah God, be with us, even as I share your word. May you minister to me, that Heavenly Father, I'll be able to minister to your people, and through my mouth and your word, each one of us will be ministered to. For this is my prayer, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
Morning.
I am fine. I'm Kadam Jane. I thank God so sincerely this morning for giving me an opportunity to come and share his word. With me, I came with my husband and our son. If they wave, the congregation are appreciated. I'll continue to introduce them. There he is, there they are. Appreciate them. A month is not over yet, so Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
I want to share this morning, but just before I share, I want to sincerely appreciate all those who joined me and the Bishop on Wednesday for the official opening of our St. Paul's commercial building. And therefore, thank you for finding time. I was very, very happy indeed. And also the Bishop was very, very impressed and very happy. The buildings are now officially open, and we thank God. Thank you, choir. When I saw you there, I felt that was wow. That was wonderful. You made the occasion very nice, and therefore, may that spirit continue. Actually, I want to cite what the Bishop said. He said that on Wednesday, it's like now he has remembered those very old days that Moro used to be Moro. He has seen that Moro, and my prayer is that spirit will continue, and we will continue to join hearts together for the honor and glory of our God. Praise the name of the Lord. My sermon today is taken from our diocesan theme for the year. We know last year, because of closing the church, we were not able to exhaust our theme, and therefore our theme this year is as the one we had last year. The theme is for last year. We are continuing with that theme, and I am sure God will continue to bless us. And our theme is taken from the book of Matthew, the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 7, reading from verse 27 through to 24 to 27. And it talks about a wise man builds his house on a firm foundation. And when I was thinking about this, and when I came tomorrow, this is a very old church. Very, very old church. But the church is beautiful. It is intact because the pillars that were put, they were firm. They were strong. And that is why even today, we cannot be worried when we are in this sanctuary because the pillars are firm. You can imagine, if the pillars could not be firm, nearly all of us, we would be looking up and wondering, will it fall on us? But we thank God that the builders there were very wise, they were helped by God, and they were able to put good pillars. When you read this reading from verse 24 through to 27, we see the two house builders. And the Bible is very clear, because it is saying that so then anyone who hears these words of mine and obeys them is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain poured down, the rivers overflowed, and the wind blew hard against that house, but it did not fall because it was built on the rock. But anyone who hears these words of mine and does not obey them is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain poured down, the rivers overflowed, the wind blew hard against that house, and it fell. And what a terrible fall that was. We should notice that in this passage, that the storm we see here was the same for both houses. Both houses experienced the storm. And the storm was not easy. But for both houses, Jesus says, the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew. Jesus tells us the same trials come to both of them. It was a very big trial because they had both taken their time to build their houses. Both of them experienced hard rain, both of them experienced floods, and both of them experienced a very hard wind. This means in our lives as Christians, the same will happen to us. We will get sick sometimes, and I'm sure many people have experienced sicknesses in their families, even themselves. Even myself, I've also experienced some sicknesses sometimes back. Sometimes you can get, even our family members can get really very sick. But we thank God because He's always in control. We shall still have problems with our jobs. Like last year, nearly all people had difficulties. Many people who are working, biashara zao, their kazi zao, ziliweza kuisha. Wengine even they were sacked. Those are challenges of this life. Marriages also. Last year, if there were years that people experienced challenges in their marriages, it was last year. Because for them that are not used to staying together, they were together from March up to December. And you know, when you are not home always, people do not know how to behave when their spouses, when their children are at home. And actually, I remember some of the parents were asking, when are our children going to go back to school? Imagine, they are our own children. But when they are home, we are not very comfortable because they are disturbing. They are doing things that are not right. You are there to keep watch on over them. Others were complaining that the budgets were very high because when they are home, and they are not even doing anything, they are only eating, they consumed a lot. And therefore, that was also a challenge. And therefore, these are challenges that even Christians experienced. And many others, I cannot even be able to name them because there are so many. Those are like rain, floods, and wind. There is rain, floods and weeds for everyone in this life. You have your day when you experience a challenge. It is compared to rain or floods or weed. But everyone must experience that in his or her life. Those who build their life on the rock, as well as those who build their life on the sand. The storms of life are common to us all. The storms are common to all of us. None of us can stand and say, I never face storms in my life. Me, I'm okay because I'm very comfortable. Me, I'm okay because I am so contented. The storms of life are common to us all. The difference is not that you don't have storms. As a Christian, the difference is that as a Christian, you have a foundation that holds you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You have a foundation that makes the whole difference. That is why I'm talking about the difference that, as a Christian, you have a foundation that holds you up through the storm. You know, there are people, when storms come, they look for different things because they want to run away from the storms. But those that have a firm foundation, they hold on that firm foundation. As followers of Jesus, rain, flood, and wind, and all kinds of trials in our lives will come. As a canon, I want to promise that being a Christian does not mean you'll walk free. You'll have many storms. You'll have many challenges. You'll have many difficulties. But I want to encourage you this morning that you should have a foundation that will be able to hold you up throughout the storms you could be facing. Let's, when we talk about those storms, let's experience them with peace. When you are facing trials, temptations, storms, kindly I want to encourage you to face them with a lot of peace. That peace that only Jesus can be able to give you. You need to have a firm foundation that you'll be able to stand the storm with a lot of peace. What do I mean? I want to mean that when you are faced by so many storms, kindly pray that God will give you peace. He promised that He will give us peace, that no human being can be able to grant us that peace. So when you are faced with trials, storms, temptations, difficulties, challenges, problems, face them with peace. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Face them also with strength. Actually, the psalm which was read to us very clearly, it was talking about God gives us strength when we need it. And you know, God is very, very true to His word. He is able to follow His word to bring it to accomplishment. When you only mention the word of God to Him, He is able to give you strength. He is able to give you peace. And you will be able to stand. We shall be able to stand and we shall not fall if we have built our lives upon the rock. When I was going through this text, I cannot even be able to expound it completely because it has a lot. Because on verse 24, so building your house on the rock means doing what Jesus says. That is what it means by building your house on the rock. And what does it mean by building your house on the sand? It means not doing what Jesus says or what Jesus requires. And when I was going through, I was getting very encouraged that we must be doers of the word, not just hearers. We must do exactly what Jesus requires of us, that we will be able to be sure that we have built our houses on a firm foundation. Our firm foundation should be the house that is built on the rock. How practical are you? Do you do exactly what Jesus requires, or you don't? When we talk about building our houses, like the house we are in right now, it has very firm pillars and it is a firm foundation. It is meaning that when we are here and the word of God is spoken to us, we should pray that we should be doers of the word, not only hearers of the word. And actually that one can get it very well from the book of James. Here Jesus is interested in us doing what he says. When Jesus is watching over us, he is desiring that we continue to do what he says. If he says the year 2021 is an assignment that he has given you, kindly pray that you'll be able to do it. Both men heard what Jesus said, but one acted on the word, but the other did not. We are many here in this sanctuary. There are those that will heed to the word of God. They will be prepared to act on the word of God. But there are those that will hear the word of God. They will not take any action. My appeal, my prayer to you this morning, even myself, is that God will help me and will help you, that you'll be able to act on the word of God. Once we hear, let's not just be comfortable because we have heard, but let's be comfortable because the word of God has been spoken and we are willing to act on that word of God. That was why the fall was so terrible for that person who didn't act, for that person who just built his house and he felt he was comfortable because the house was complete. Where are you, my brother? Where are you, my sister? The year 2021, what are you purposing with your foundation? Which is your foundation? What are you purposing for this year? Are you purposing to act? Are you purposing to do what God requires of you? What is your purpose? Now that God has given you another year, he has given me another year, will there be a difference or it will just be a year like any other? The only joy will be that the year 2021 will be a year with a difference because it is you, it is me who will bring the difference. Praise the name of the Lord. My prayer is that all of us will purpose to have a firm foundation. Will your foundation stand the storm? The year will continue to unfold because we only know of today, we only know of now, but God knows about tomorrow and the day after tomorrow and even in future. Once the year continues to unfold, will your foundation stand the storm? Because we do not know what we are expecting, but we are trusting God that the year will be a fantastic year, the year will be good. But even the changes, will your foundation stand the storm? It can only stand if it is on a firm foundation. So today I'm talking on a firm foundation. How is your foundation? How is my foundation? There are things that we need to do so that our foundations can continue to be firm. Number one, we need Bible studies. If you've never done Bible study in your homes, kindly, the year 2020 taught us a lesson. Because we are encouraged to do Bible study in our homes. I don't know whether you started or not. If you started, well and good. If you never started, you are not great. You can as well continue and have a Bible study. Choose a book for your family that you need to do together as a family. That you bring a firm foundation. Therefore, I don't know how many people are doing Bible studies at home. Maybe even in this church, I don't know whether we have a Bible study. But because today I have a PCC, I will be able to run more. And if there is no Bible study, we'll also purpose to start one because we need a firm foundation. Let's now forget about the building and the pillars. Let's focus on our hearts. because God is interested in what our heart hold, and therefore we need a firm foundation as far as the word of God is concerned. Reading the Bible, I don't know how often you read the word of God. I don't know whether you do it in a daily basis. I am not sure. But because it is you are able to answer that question very well. Because if you do not do it, purpose to do it in the year 2021. Fellowships, I thank God that I have grant in St. Albans. We have 9 meters. Actually, there are very many, but you try to cope with them. That means we are many, and we thank God for that. Where I'm coming from, I had only 4 meters. So I was added at the 5, double plus 1. I thank God so much. Are you a member of those fellowships? In your mutaa, do you attend the fellowship? It will help you to have a firm foundation. Because I tend to think that is why the meters were started, so that they can help us to have a firm foundation. Prayer. I don't know whether the church is open here in Moro for people to come and seek their God in prayer. I don't know even whether we have a monthly prayer for all of us. These are things that will help us to be firm. These are things that will help us to have buildings that will not be shaky. Buildings that even as the storms will come, they will all stand. All this will help our foundations to be firm. What do you desire this year? Do you desire to have a Bible study? Do you desire to read the Bible day after day? Do you desire to continue fellowshipping with other brethren? I wonder whether last year you took time to meet with other brethren for fellowship. If you didn't, you are not ready even today. Fellowships are very, very important. And actually, if I can be able to quote Paul, he says in the book of Hebrews 10:23 that we should not refuse to come together. We should always come together for encouragement, for prayer, for fellowship, and for building one another up. You can imagine if Paul was able to do that and to encourage his followers that meeting together is important. I want to emphasize even today that meeting together is vital. It is very important. My prayer to us is that God will help us to have firm foundation. The Bible is saying, a wise man built his house on a firm foundation. You know, you don't call a person wise or foolish, but once you read the Bible and I've given the explanation, you will be able to rate yourself and you will be able to know where you are. As far as spiritual beings are concerned, where are you, my sister, my brother? Can we rate you as a wise person or a foolish person? Remember, the fall was very terrible. That is what the Bible says. And what a terrible fall that was. My prayer is, neither of us will fall, because all our foundations will be built on a firm foundation. May we desire to continue building our houses on the rock. May we desire to continue to do exactly what Jesus requires of us. If he says we do something, then we should join hearts and do it just for his own glory. And it is in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God bless you.
utumie kulitukuza jina lako. Nisamehe baba yangu, mimi ni mwenye dhambi, ninaomba msamaha. Nisamehe baba yangu, mimi ni mwenye dhambi, ninaomba msamaha.
Baba wetu na Mungu wetu ishie mbele katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Twainama mbele zako kutambua ukuu wako. Twainama mbele zako kukuenzi sana mfalme wa ajabu. Ni kwa sababu wewe ni mwema na ni mwaminifu. Tazama ubali huu Bwana umekuwa pamoja nasi, umetushughulikia kwa njia nyingi na tuna sababu zote za kukuambia asante. Tunapoinama wakati huu Bwana mbele zako, tuwaleta wote ambao wanahitaji maombi yetu mbele zako. Tukikumbuka mke wa Lilida Mwaura, baba uishie milele ni asante. Kwa sababu alipoenda upasuaji Bwana, ulienda vyema na yeye. Ukamshindania Bwana. Asante kwa sababu ya ubali huu, maana wanashuhudia ya kwamba umekuwa mwema. Tazama baba ile kazi huwa wanafanya hapa kanisani. Mama kama mwana kwaya, Mesa Mwaura kama Lilida. Baba uishie milele na waombea neema yako na msaada wako na nguvu zako katika jina la Yesu. Ya kwamba wakati huu wanapopitia hiyo changamoto, baba utapitia pamoja na wao. Baba utawashindania na baba utawainulia uso wako wa msaada na wa nguvu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Nasi kama kanisa, kazi yetu ni kusimama pamoja na wao. Kazi yetu ni kuwaombea Bwana. Tusaidie Mwokozi wetu. Tukaweza kuwa wa baraka kwa hiyo familia, kama vile ambavyo wamekuwa wa baraka kwa kanisa kwa sababu ya huduma zao Bwana. Tuatume neno la uponyaji kwao katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Asante kwa sababu mchana wa leo utawatenda mema. Mchana wa leo utawainulia uso wako katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Baba ni asante pia kwa sababu ya Dorcas Maina, ambaye jana ilikupendeza ukampumzisha baba yake. Baba uishie mbele, mioyo yao imeinama, wamekosa nguvu, wako na majonzi Bwana. Tuwainua kwako Mwokozi, uishie mbele. Wewe ambaye unasema faraja zote zinatoka kwako, omba ya kwamba ukawakumbuka, ukawafariji, ukawapa nguvu Bwana na ukawa msaada wao, wakaweza kukukimbilia Bwana kwa sababu wanakuhitaji wakati huu. Baba ni asante kwa sababu uko pamoja na wao. Baba ni asante kwa sababu utawavuta machozi. Baba ni asante kwa sababu hata mipango ikianza na kuendelea, utasimama pamoja na wao Mungu wetu. Nasi kama kanisa, omba ya kwamba ukatusaidia kusimama na wao katika jina la Yesu Kristo, ili tukaweza kuwa wa baraka kwao, na baba ukaweza kutuinulia uso wako, ili kama vile ambavyo neno lako linasema, tukaweza kulia na baba wanalia. Wakati udoka Ismaili na familia wakilia Bwana, tusaidie baba kusimama na wao katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Baba, kuna wengine wengi ambao wanahitaji maombi yetu. Baba mwema na mwenye huruma, na wainua wote kwako Bwana, ukakutana na wao mchana wa leo, ukawashindania Bwana, ukawapa matumaini, na baba uishie milele, ukawasaidia, ukawainulia hali zao zote Bwana, wakaweza kuinuka na kusimama tena katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Na kama vile ambavyo neno lako limetukumbusha, wasaidie kusimama kwa msingi ambao
kuongezeka. Ingawa watapitia dhoruba na mambo mengi na changamoto nyingi, wasaidia wakaweza kusimama imara katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Kani kwa sababu ya kila mmoja wetu ambaye alihudhuria ibada yetu, Baba, nawainua kwako sasa, ukawabariki, ukawatenda mema, ukawainulia uso wako. Wiki ambayo tunaianza siku ya kesho, twaikabidhi mikononi mwako Bwana. Pahara pote kila mmoja wetu atakuwa, twaomba neema yako na nguvu zako na msaada wako Bwana, maana tuwatakuwa bila wewe hatutaweza. Kwa hivyo endelea ukisimama nasi kwa shughuli zetu tofauti tofauti Bwana, ukashughulika pamoja nasi, ukawa mwema na ukakuwa mwaminifu, maana tumekuona ukiwa mwema na ukiwa mwaminifu. Na sasa mikononi mwako Bwana tuwajikabidhi, tukiomba baraka zako na msaada wako. Na sasa amani ya Mungu ipitayo fahamu zote iwalinde mioyo yenu na nia zenu katika hali ya kumjua na kumpenda Mungu na mwana wake Yesu Kristo. Na baraka ya Mungu Mwenyezi, Baba na Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu iwe kwenu sasa na ikaishi nanyi daima.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We have come. Powerful healer. You are the powerful healer. Come and heal. So powerful, so powerful today. And you will heal. So powerful today.